rather.
Yes, we do. Yes, because there's not many of that.
Specially.
We've done them all special, that's why I didn't want you
to what you like. Yeah.
Mum? Yeah? Look at that on the wall.
Oh, it's an ice cream, Phil. Pint?
The early history of Burgh Island is as fascinating as its enchantment and magic is today. At one time it was known as St. Michael's, named after the ancient chapel which once stood on the top, although today there are no remains at all. It then became known as Lubber, in the 15th century it became Burgh, and eventually it became known by its present name. Saint Michael the Archangel is the patron saint of mariners, and his medieval chapel also acted as a beacon and warning to ships when a light was placed on the tower in stormy weather.
Nearby pub, isn't it?
Yeah.
Maybe.
Is that the loo in the middle there?
Crap in the hole.
Is there a fireplace there?
Visitors to Bigbury Bay and Burgh Island today would imagine that in the immediate neighbourhood there was such a large fishing industry, giving employment to many people. It has been suggested that the rights for fishing were originally granted as far back as medieval times by the priors of Buckfast Abbey.
You're good at doing things that where it says don't do this or don't do that.
That's how we've done it, that's fine, isn't it? Well, I didn't see it, so I won't say don't jump on it. Look at that feather. Look at the feather.
This is almost a bit like picked granite you got drunk.
Turn the other way facing
him. Knock!
Oh, Mum!
Stephen, face the
cliff. Sit ourselves down at the cliff there. I'll sit down there.
Here you go.
Roger went down there. Alex and Vivian. They got up
all
right.
Yeah.
Didn't they?
Should
we wake you in the
pub? Ran off and tried leaving behind. We couldn't.
They can't get up from that bit. They know it had to be.
Well, everybody else around here, you can see where they've climbed up.
I know, but I'm there. It's a bit...
Mark,
Steve!
Nashes. Grab signs for tea?
Yeah. That's one of his friends.
C sadly, all that is left to remind us of this industry is the pilchard inn on the island, an industry which was the main livelihood and of generations of local people. Dates back to the 14th century, a time when a monastical community lived here grazing sheep. The inn is completely unspoilt. Is steeped in folklore of the dim past, the one-time haunt of pirates and smugglers led by none other than the notorious Tom Crocker. This is actually what you're looking at now, a pirate's cave where they'd bury their treasure. Burgh Island is an island of romance, adventure and treasure. Tom Crocker, Prince of Smugglers, evaded capture for many years until eventually he was trapped and seized by the customs men and shot outside the inn. A pirate flag and carving bearing the likeness of Crocker, both of which can be seen in the pilchard inn, commemorate the event. Gone are the smugglers, gone are the pirates. The bold, bad men who come ashore today come in search of the greatest treasure of modern days, health and rest. Gone too is the pirate flag, believed to have disappeared during the war when the Ministry of Defence took over the island. Too, that during the Second World War, Churchill and Eisenhower met on this island. Bigbury Bay and Burgh Island in particular have played a role in several films. They have also inspired several great writers to let loose their imagination. At the other end of Bigbury Bay, where the Erm pours into the sea, the sequel to National Velvet was made. International Velvet starred Tatum O'Neill, Nanette Newman, Anthony Hopkins and Christopher Plummer, This film's opening and closing sequences were filmed with some superb aerial photography showing this stretch of coastline and in the distance the China clay pits on the edge of Dartmoor. The legendary Kirk Douglas also has visited Bigbury Bay when in 1975 he shot a scene for the film Holocaust 2000. The director was obviously aware of the rare tidal phenomena of an incoming tide on the two sides of the natural causeway to the island and used this to good effect, and the star had to run for his life to reach safety on the mainland. In the film Catch Us If You Can, a group of youngsters flee to a lonely island in the West Country. They run across the sands to the waiting tractor and alight onto a landing platform to look around the deserted hotel. Looking out of the window and seeing the smooth sands covered with people, the heroine dismisses the island with the words, "It's not even a proper island, it's just a gimmick in the sea." Hopefully you will disagree, and if you're like us, you will see it is a very magical and special place.
Well, we made it.
Film the footballers.